back. A very good morning and welcome back to the Rush Hour. This is the big issue. Now we want actually to get into another issues, but before we do that, we asked you a question on will the opposition deal, unity deal actually hold? Will the opposition unity deal hold? You can still go on our social media platforms at Urban TV, Uganda on Twitter, on Facebook, Urban Television. Drop your comment there. And we'll be reading those comments. Lynn Komjisha, let me just actually take you through the comments that are coming in from the public. That's this Facebook. Mm-hmm. They can't unite because they all of them want big position. That's coming in from Zita Georgie. Thank you so much for watching us. Sherina Nase says, Nara, nothing will happen. What happened to Red Card Movement? They launched cause Nalaba, almost every opposition person was present that day. Didn't Bessie just say the Red Card was about giving him 700 days?
Exactly what I was telling you.
When he's out of power. So what happened after? None talks about it anymore. Time wasters, just Museveni puts up election, they will participate. That's coming in from Sherina Nance. And then Poplot says, Mr. Besigye has to be more wise enough, because what happened in 2016 by-elections? Bobby lost faith, popularity, vision, and trust, but now he's reconciling. Mutwe Noah says, Bonaba Chimanyi no mutima mbu, nothing will yield from why going to expensive hotels to discuss issues affecting Ugandans.
but I was telling you.
And then Charles Robert Odu says, with Bobby Wine in the crew, give it 2 months. Oh my God.
We'll be no more.
You can actually still join that conversation on our social media platforms at Urban TV Uganda, on Twitter, on Facebook. Urban Television. Lynn, actually, right. What do you think about this before we get into another discussion?
I have told you, I'm telling you once again, this opposition unity or whatever shenanigans they are up to is never going to hold.
Why do you think that the one between Mao and NRM will work? Will hold, and then this one won't hold?
They are visionary people. They are focused. They know what they want.
Are you calling Norbert Mao visionary?
Yes, he's always been visionary. I'm sure you've seen, even in his manifestos, there's a vision. Mm. But listen, these people, no.
Actually, this working agreement between these opposition political parties comes ahead a few days after National Resistance Movement got actually victory in Soroti East by election, seeing Herbert Ariko from the NRM winning that position against FDC's Moses Atan, who was tussling it out. But of course, concerns still came up to criticize in the manner in which Electoral Commission managed this by election. The biggest question that came out was, why do we always have these by elections in a very violent way? Couldn't we have these by-elections in a much more orderly way? We want now to pick actually comments and also the position of Electoral Commission on how better we can actually have these by-elections in a much peaceful way. And joining us in studios to discuss that is Mr. Paul Wakenya, the Electoral Commission spokesperson. A very good morning, Paul, and welcome to Rush Hour. Hello, Mr. Paul Wakenya, are you hearing us, and could you really... Hello, we can't really have Mr. Paul now. It seems like his network, technical things. Paul Wakenya must be joining us from Electoral Commission headquarters there in Kampala, and of course we just want to hear from him. Mr. Paul Wakenya, a very good morning and welcome to Rush Hour. Hello, Paul Wakenya, are you getting us?
Sorry about that.
I think we have a very technical issue there coming in from Electoral Commission spokesperson. He must be joining us from Electoral Commission headquarters. Remember, we are broadcasting live from Vision Group headquarters here in Industrial Area, and we asked a question on our social media platforms. Will the opposition deal hold? Will the opposition unity deal hold? Join that conversation on our social media platforms at Urban TV Uganda, on Facebook Hello. And Urban Television. A very good morning, Paul, and welcome Hello. To Rush Hour. Do you hear us, Paul? Are you getting us?
It's okay. I think we need
to first get that.
On my laptop, it's set.
Oh, sorry about that. But you know, Mubarak, still on that, as we, as we will continue to hope that Paul Bukenya can join us. This particular agreement was that in the coming by-elections, they are supposed to unite as a whole and make sure that they beat the NRA.
Yes.
But we have seen how that has played out. Over the years, we have seen, it's not the first time. Mm-hmm. It's not the first time. They always wanted to join together and, you know, make all the necessary noise. And at the end of the day, NRA beats them. We ought to ask the opposition, what are you not doing right?
But I think this time around, I understand there is a lot to discuss about by-elections and why they actually turn out to be violent in so many places. But the biggest question is, we have always been hearing people talking about opposition unity and all that. Mm-hmm. But actually, the reality is, this time around, the opposition was united. We saw Dr. Kizza Besigye and Tshabalala on the same platform, but they still got actually to be defeated. But then let's join Paul Bukenya. We are made to understand that actually he can now hear us. A very good morning, Paul Bukenya, and welcome to Rush Hour. Hello, Mr. Paul Bukenya. Do you get us and do you hear us? Unfortunately, we cannot have Mr. Paul Bukenya online. We're connecting him from Electoral Commission headquarters here at Campus Ginger Road. And of course, we still have those technical issues, but we'll come back to him when that technical problem is sorted.
The opposition is saying they're going to court, and they're taking the Electoral Commission to court.
Yes.
Why do... I've always wondered. Mm-hmm. Maybe I need education. Why do they fail and then blame it on the Electoral Commission?
So certainly, those are interesting questions. But anyway, it's. I just wanted to look at a bigger picture of this whole electoral process.
Yeah.
I think where the biggest problem comes from is when. What should be the roles of the Electoral Commission and where should be the limits? Where should be the limits with the police? Because sometimes last time we saw clips of NRM officials directing the police to arrest some agents
of the opposition parties. Yes.
And certainly many of the opposition are posing questions. Should actually orders of arrest be made by those officials of the NRM or should be made by actual officials of the Electoral Commission? Because and these are issues that still come up, and we need to have a streamlined, process on how we can hold these by-elections.
Mm.
But also, one thing that I have come to realize is that however much we also talk about these violent incidents that happen in these by-elections, by and large, we have seen a much more peaceful by-election until the election day.
Yes.
In Soroti.
Yes.
We have not actually had instances of violence before elections take place.
That's just true.
Campaigns have been held in a much more organized way.
Well,
not until the last day.
With a few days, they started heating up when different political heads started heading to the Soroti. I still think maybe these political heads kind of bring a certain feel to the campaign.
Yes.
And once the feel is felt by the voters, then it becomes like a tug of war. It becomes like, I need to show my person, I need to show my chairperson, for example, or my president of the party, that I am doing something. So I don't know what happens.
And sometimes, that's a very interesting, actually, perspective, because we have seen that these by-elections mostly has a lot to do with party big winks than just actually the candidates.
Exactly.
And you see, it's now this by-election. By-election.
And what's funny is that the winner will say, because the president went there. So, what have you been doing at, on the campaign trail?
Absolutely.
Why should your president come and in support, of course? I don't know.
So certainly you saw what happened in Soroti. The election actually moved from Herbert Arico.
Yes.
And Moses Satan and Pasco Amriat.
And when?
And then it went to Mike Mukula.
Uh-huh.
And then Patrick Amriat Oboy.
And also the VP.
And then President.
And then
Dr. Besigye. And then Vice President. And then Chagulanyi there. So it's mostly. And actually, we are also seeing. Is it Bulimbili? Bukimbili.
Bukimbili. Yes.
That side of Kisoro.
Yes.
We are having a by-election.
Yes.
And also we are having another one in Palisa.
And another one in Kasses.
Exactly. So we now see that yesterday I was seeing news updates coming in, and it seems Dr. Chris Variomwensi. This is going to be about Dr. Chris. Yes, a big win.
I mean, the vice chairperson. He's the NRM chairperson.
Of Western Uganda.
Yeah.
So mostly it's going to be about Dr. Chris Variomwensi,
mm-hmm.
and maybe the FDC big wig, ONUP big wig in that region.
In that region.
And then the election,
moves away from the candidate
to, and the issues that actually affect the people
this,
there.
This actually reminds me of a normal workplace, uh-huh. where somebody's going, oh, but I know so-and-so, you know, I can talk to them. You know this thing.
Yes.
So, I don't know if it is an issue of I think if I bring the president here, mm-hmm. or if I bring the principal, for example, mm-hmm. Robert Chagulanyi, I mean, people are going to look at Chagulanyi and forget that there is a candidate.
Yes.
And this I blame on our people, because you must stay focused and know that if I vote so-and-so, this is what they're going to bring to the table.
Should there actually be an amendment that stops big wigs from actually going to those areas?
Are you seeing what's happening in Kenya?
I mean, we can actually say that those by-elections should be held by the people who are hailing from that place.
Only.
Then you will have actually an issue.
It doesn't make sense.
You will not have issues. No, it makes sense, by the way.
Why I'm saying it doesn't make sense is because, I mean, we would want to see that your party actually supports you.
No, but certainly we have seen violent incidents happening. You saw what happened in Arua.
Yes.
Certainly, the person who was there, it was not a clash. The person who caused the scuffle in Arua has never been even to Arua.
It was a clash of titans.
Exactly.
You know, they just show up and
disappear, but leave chaos behind. You saw what happened in Kayunga. the NUP candidates voted one aisle.
I don't know if the Electoral Commission has a say in all this. I don't know if the Electoral Commission can actually stand and say, you know what, you're going to confuse our people, our mm-hmm. voters,
mm-hmm.
you're going to confuse our candidates.
Yes.
How about you support them from there?
From a distance?
Don't show up.
So the only people that would be maybe allowed to be there.
So this is the amendment you are talking about?
Yes, this amendment I'm talking about, like if you are going to have a by-election in Kisoro, a by-election in Kisoro must be held for the people of Kisoro.
Absolutely.
And by the people of Kisoro.
Bukimbili, especially.
Exactly. And they must be, you know, rotating around the issues that are affecting the people of Kisoro.
That's right.
Because I'm imagining all the majority of the people who were arrested in Soroti East by-elections are certainly not actually people from that area.
Yeah, agreed.
There are people, you know, you find an MP from Kunjiri is arrested in Soroti.
And this is
what
why
are you doing there?
This is why I start blaming the Electoral Commission for one reason.
Mm.
This means that you're going to bring in non-voters.
Mm-hmm.
This also means that chances are the register is going to be tampered with. You will have people. This is where the comments of ferrying in people from different places are coming.
But you're also ferrying in agents.
Exactly. So it becomes...
If you have really a strong party,
yeah.
and there is a structure that has been there, because I certainly know that in a general election,
yes.
all these people that we saw in these by-elections were not there. They were fighting for their positions in their own areas. Can't we have at least another amendment, maybe in the Parliamentary Elections Act, and these elections, the by-elections,
yes.
should be held in a much more special way,
and should even be less expensive.
Certainly, because the reason why they are this expensive is because everybody's attention is in that election. I know people are going to come up and argue.
Maybe,
you know,
Mubarak, you need to educate me. Mm. What is so special about these by-elections?
Because every attention is there. And, you know, politicians can as well be idle at some point, because this isn't an election day, rather an election time. So all of them will be looking at this by-election
to show
that actually they still exist.
To show
face. But if you really have a strong party, and these, if you really have a strong structure,
yeah,
you have, we have been hearing, NRM has, I don't know how many, 20 people on each village. You hear DP was here telling us that they have 4 million people in the register. If you have those people, why don't you use those people on the ground when an election actually happens in your place?
Because we don't trust them. And this is where the legitimacy of especially these political parties, but also of the Electoral Commission, is questioned.
And I think the Electoral Commission has really done its part.
I think it needs to tighten a little bit.
Because, I mean, you certainly are not going to have a 100% perfect election.
Of course.
That doesn't exist anywhere, except in the election of the Pope, maybe. We don't know what happens there. We don't know what happens inside there. But I don't think you're
Unless
going to have
not
a perfect election.
Yes.
The fact that you can have an election and the process goes on well, of course, with some instances, you know, lawyers will tell you, you know, there is this technicality or there is this problem that happened during the, you know, the process, so it affects the results. That's another argument. The whole issue is, why would you actually have the whole political party structure going into one constituency with only 20, 30,000 people? Causing havoc there. And then when they get out today, if people voted Mukula, for example,
okay,
or if people voted for Amriat, for example, or if people voted for President Museveni, or people voted for Dr. Kizza Besigye, behind in the name of the candidate that is standing before there, today they are not in sorority.
Yes.
Today it is time to face your Herbert Arico, or it is time to face your Moses Atan.
Yes.
Now, if you had left these people to actually go on the ground, and that process is handled by the local government, whether we can even say the local government electoral commission, because we saw the returning officers from there are the ones holding, you know, announcing the declaring the winner and all that. But if we say it is only local government, let the party structure, if you don't have a party there, please.
Don't show up. But then you're denying the opposition the alliances they're trying to build.
No, if you are having an alliance between UPC and FDC,
right,
or you're having FDC and NOP alliance, there are structures of NOP in Soroti. There are structures of FDC in Soroti. What is these national leaders doing?
It does not make sense. It does not show full support. It does not bring, bring like heaven on earth.
When are you going to even test these structures, whether they are actually, you know, effective? For that matter.
That is very, I agree, that is very right.
When are you going to have local leaders, let's say, for example, a chairperson of a district?
Yes.
A party chairperson of a district is holding, is the one leading these campaigns, for example, in Soroti East. You will even have avoided these issues of saying the prime minister went there as a prime minister, not as a member of the National Resistance Movement.
And we could have also perhaps avoided the arrests of the different members of parliament.
Absolutely.
That went in support of another
candidate.
Our
legislators need to think about how better these by-elections can as well be held and can be conducted.
You see, my other problem I have with the opposition is the fact that they make noise, they point fingers, but they're not giving us alternatives. They're not giving us alternatives. If they go to parliament and say, we need to amend ABCD and, you know, include what we have been talking about, for example, And the opposition is going to be like, no, it doesn't make sense. They're not giving you an alternative.
Certainly, it's something that many politicians will not buy into.
Yes.
But I think it can as well provide a very long-term remedy.
Absolutely.
For these violent by-elections. Uh-huh. Because all the violent by-elections that we've had actually are not the victims. The losers are the people in that constituency.
That's true. That's
at the end of the day, because they do not get an opportunity to discuss the issues that affect them.
And you know what kills me?
Mm.
After these members of parliament have made it to parliament, they forget about their constituencies. They go live large.
Because you never voted. You never voted for them. You voted for the party bigwigs. You voted for, because you saw Dr. Besigye is there, you vote for the person because Dr. Besigye is there. You saw President Museveni is there, you vote for the person because President Museveni is there.
The principle shows up and everybody goes wild.
Exactly. And we have seen nearly all these by-elections, the people who are involved
but in
these violent scenes
are
people who are not coming from those
areas. Exactly, and that's the saddest bit. But where is the Electoral Commission here? What does it do?
But the Electoral Commission...
Are you saying it has failed?
No, it's not failed. The Electoral Commission has, it has laws that actually it has to fulfill.
I agree.
There is no law today that stops Yulin from going to Kisoro to campaign for another individual.
That's
there is no
true.
Law that would actually stop a Patrick Amuriat or a doctor or a prime minister from going to campaign for somebody in a specific place.
Mm-hmm.
But my whole issue is, we can have an arrangement of saying, if a by-election falls in a place, this by-election, you are not allowed to ferry in people, regardless of whether they are leaders of that party or not.
Can they hold like Zoom calls and campaign for their people?
You want them to ferry the one of Paul has.
Paul Bukeja really has, but
certainly these are very interesting discussions that we may have.
Mm.
And our legislators need to pick this up. Because these violent elections, I saw the one of Arua.
Yeah.
You have Chagula. He's not a born of Arua. Honestly, why would you have...
And he ferried the entire ghetto crew.
Exactly. And whoever was arrested in there, they were not even 10% was from Arua. Then you having, let's say today, maybe you would forgive the Adekes. But I saw the Deputy Lord Mayor being arrested from that side.
Deputy Lord Mayor of Kampala.
Of
what
Kampala
were you doing
City.
in Soroti?
What would you be doing in Soroti? We saw Prime Minister going in there, launching whatever things that she was launching. But then it creates a conflict. In the area where this by-election is going to be held.
Can't
we say, today...
Think elections world over were made in a way that they should be, very interesting scenes. Because I don't... Still, Mubarak, whereas we are castigating the opposition for, and everybody else for always, showing face when they are not called, I think it shows... support. It shows some sort of it breeds some sort of trust in a leader, in a candidate.
Mm.
So when, if for example I went, wouldn't you be my?
Yes, certainly.
Wouldn't you cheer me on?
Yes, I would cheer you. I am not. By the way, let me tell you, Lynn, I'm not opposed
to the support
and to. All of these candidates, of these members, whoever wants to go to. Any place to campaign for their candidates.
Can it be peaceful?
It is okay. It is very okay. And it is allowed by the law.
Mm.
And I am not opposed to that kind of arrangement.
Mm-hmm.
And I am not opposed. I feel happy when I see President Museveni goes to campaign for a person.
I also
certainly.
Do.
And it adds value to that candidate.
But I also feel
I feel
happy.
Okay
uh-huh.
when Dr. Besigye Ochagulanyi goes to campaign for their fellow candidates.
Mm.
This time round in Soroti, they were very, very orderly in that manner. They could not clash on the routes to take. That's why you did not see any violence during the campaigns.
Until...
But my question, and my concern is that in an election is meant to be a process where people can freely choose a leader that actually tackles their issues, their problems, presents issues to them.
Mm.
in the event that these big wigs actually appear there, the debate of issues that affect the local communities shifts. So how do we make sure that this debate doesn't shift?
Okay. Maybe it is the, maybe that's the whole idea.
Yes. No. Why?
Maybe
no,
that's
no,
the
no,
whole
no.
idea.
It shouldn't be the whole idea.
It might be the whole idea. Listen to me. It might be the whole idea in a sense that if they show up, people will stop pointing fingers. This one is not going to deliver. This one, because clearly they're seeing that the party's behind them.
Certainly, I may agree with that, but also, you know, it is not right for the debate to shift.
But it has to.
The debate should be on the issues. I think the whole idea of elections and democracy is for people to present their case, right? Now, if you have these big wigs appearing on those in these constituencies, the opportunity for actually candidates to present their cases to the people is shrinks.
Yes.
The first time.
That's right.
But also, the debate shifts from Moses Atan, from Herbert Ariko, to Dr. Besigye and President Museveni. And sometimes it also shifts from a Mike Mukula to a Patrick Amuriat Oboi.
Mm-hmm.
I think this is a disservice to the people of that constituency.
But
the people must be able to discuss what are you going to do differently.
But the question is, are the voters literally seeing what's happening and appreciating, or are they carried away? Do they want to actually, you know, get the candidates and quiz them? Are you able to deliver ABCD? Can you do ABCD for us? Or when they see the big wigs, they're carried away like, ha! Museveni is around, some envelope.
Although the party, we are in a multi-party dispensation, and we understand that actually these parties have to, you know, present their cases. They already have manifestos.
Yes.
They know what actually they are going to, you know, to talk to do to their people. But also, it is not right, however much you see that the candidates are presenting their manifestos, we should give an opportunity for local people to determine which is the best candidate. And we can only do that by restricting people who should go in a particular area in a certain by-election.
That's right.
And of course, we shall continue with that discussion. On our social media platforms, we asked you earlier on, will the opposition unity deal actually hold? You can join that conversation on our social media platforms at Urban TV Uganda on Facebook, on Facebook, Urban Television, on Twitter at Urban TV Uganda. But also, you can join us on our own social media platforms at Mubarak UG, also at Lean UG3. We are going to take a short break, but when we return, we have actually to talk about humanitarian service organs. How do we actually help one another to have a good life? Miles Ramity returns with a Rush Talk. We are taking a short break. We are returning in a while.